Barry Bonds gave us at least 73 reasons to cheer this season. The last three gave him a place in history. But despite his successes, Bonds has not always basked in a hero's glory. NBC's Bob Costas spoke with baseball's new home run king.
A few years ago, you were quoted as saying that when they induct you into the Hall of Fame in Cooperstown, you'll say something like, "Thank you, but you missed the show." You still feel that way, or have the last few years changed that perception?
I think this year changed. I saw a lot of changes this year. I saw the way the media treated me a lot differently. And I didn't think that I said anything different than I've said in the past.
How much of the change was in you? Did you make a conscious effort at any time to say, look, I'm having the year of my life, the focus is on me, I can change the perception of me if I act in a certain way?
I think they changed me. I didn't change. They changed me by the way they treated me. They were treated me so nicely, I responded nicely.
A friend of yours likes you very much, told me recently that he thought in the past you brought some of it on yourself, the reputation for being rude, for being moody, not all the time, but some of the times, for being distant from your teammates, not showing up a couple of times for the team picture, that sort of thing, that you brought it on yourself. Is he right to any extent?
No, because I'm not the only person who didn't show up for team pictures. Okay, I'm just the only person who just stood out for it. But I wasn't the only one.
And you just said yourself you enjoyed this year more because you felt more warmth. So does it sting you, or have you built up enough armor that it doesn't when Rick Riley writes on the back page of Sports Illustrated that the score in the Giant clubhouse is 24-1?
No,
Bonds is one and the rest of the team is the other 24.
I don't worry about what somebody else does. I don't have any control over what Rick Riley writes, so it doesn't bother me. He embarrassed himself. You know, that's that thing. He embarrassed himself. You know, when that thing came out, my thing is God doesn't like ugly. You know, so he has to deal with that. He has to go to sleep thinking about that all the time. That man doesn't know anything about me, nothing personally about me or anything. I'm fine with it because I know who I am as a person. It's hard being, I guess you can say, the superstar or the man, because if they joke around on the field about each other and they're hitting or whatnot, or you stink or you didn't do this or whatnot, it's okay. But when I say it for fun, it's offensive.
Robin Williams is a friend of yours.
Oh, great friend.
And he says that you have a great sense of humor. He says you're funny as hell. But it's fair to say that most of the press and public isn't clued into that.
That's not their time slot for me. You know, when you're at home and you're amongst your friends, that's when I'm safest. I mean, Robin Williams is one of the closest friends I have. His family is a wonderful family. We have Christmas dinners every single year together. But we joke and we kid around, but we accept each other for who we are, and we appreciate each other for who we are. There's no double standards there. It's unconditional love.
Barry Bonds with Bob Costas, and we'll be right back. But first, this is Today on NBC.